was his name. Above on his parents he was born in Castlemaine. He was his father's only hope, his mother's pride and joy, and dearly did his parents love their wild colonial boy. He was 16 years of age when he left his father's home, and through a straight as sunny climb a bush ranger did roam. He robbed his wealthy squatters, their stock he did destroy, and a terror to Australia was the wild colonial boy. Come home, my hearties, we'll roam the mountains high. Together we will plunder, together we will die. We'll wander over valleys and gallop over plain, and scorn to live in slavery, bow down with iron chains. In 61 this daring youth commenced his wild career, with a heart that knew no danger, no foeman did he fear. Held up the Beechworth mail coach and robbed Judge McAvoy, who trembled and gave up his gold to the wild colonial boy. He bade the judge good morning and told him to beware, to never rob a hardy chap who acted on the square, and never to rob a mother of her son and only joy, or else he might turn out like the wild colonial boy. As he was riding the mountainside alone, listening to the little birds, their pleasant laughing song, three mounted troopers rode along, Kelly Davis and Fitzroy. They thought that they would capture him, the wild colonial boy.
Surrender now, Jack Dillon. You see, there's 3-1. Surrender now, Jack Dillon, you daring highwayman. He drew a pistol from his belt and he fired the wicked toy. I'll fight, but I won't surrender, said the wild colonial boy. He fired a trooper Kelly and brought him to the ground, and in return from Davis received a mortal wound. All shattered through the jaws he lay, still firing at Fitzroy. That's the way they captured him, the wild colonial boy. Slavery bound down with iron chains. That's the way they captured him, the wild colonial.